In your day-to-day work, you probably come across questions that you could answer with easy access to your business data. Like, what's the breakdown of customers by tier? Or, how has the number of IT cases changed over the past year? In Appian's Process HQ, you can use Data Fabric Insights to explore your data and build reports to answer these questions. Then, you can use Appian AI Copilot to gain deeper insights into your data, save and share your reports with stakeholders, and take action to update your data. Let's imagine I'm an analyst at a financial services company and my team fields questions from stakeholders about customer onboarding. In this video, I'll walk through building a few reports, then combine them into a dashboard for the whole team. Let's get started. You'll access Process HQ by finding it in the navigation menu. You'll start on the homepage, where you'll find processes from Process Insights, popular datasets, and reports and dashboards. To start my data exploration, I'll go to the Data Catalog on the left menu. The Data Catalog has all of the datasets that I have access to and shows the sources for each dataset. You can search, sort, and filter them to quickly find what you're looking for and display the row counts. There are two ways to create reports: by selecting any dataset or by using the guided experience to describe what you're looking for. Because I want to learn more about onboarding, I'll click the Onboarding Cases dataset. In the Report Builder, I'll start on the left where I can select fields to include. Along with onboarding data, it also has customer and account type data. As I select fields, the grid populates in the middle canvas. The right pane has setup where I can customize my report, including choosing the design and giving my report viewers ways to interact with it, like exporting it to Excel and using actions to update the data. In the grid, you can rearrange columns, and in each column, click the three dots to open the context menu. Here, you can apply groupings, calculations, formatting, and more. As I'm reviewing my grid, I notice that it has thousands of onboarding cases. I want to narrow it down to only onboarding cases currently in review. To do so, I'll go to the Setup tab and add a filter. I'll select the field I want to filter on, the operator, and then enter the value of the field in review. Before I finish, I also want my grid to display the cases with the most recent activity first. I'll add sorting and choose the field I want to sort by. Now that I have the high-level grid, I want to allow report viewers to interact with it. First, my team will want to learn more about each onboarding case. To add a link to more details, I'll open a column's context menu and select Link to Row Details. When I click this link, a new tab opens with more information about the case. Also, because my team will be using the report in our day-to-day work, we will need to update the onboarding cases. Under Interact, I'll select a few actions to include in the grid. Now, any team member can create a new case or update one. For example, let's say I need to change the net worth. I'll select the row, click the Update button, make my changes, and then the grid updates, ensuring we all have the most up-to-date information. Finally, in the top left, I'll change the report's name, add a description, and then in the top right, save it. The grid I just created only shows a list of onboarding cases. But what if I want to see a summary of my data, such as the number of cases for each account type? I can do this by aggregating the data. Here's an example. In the account type column, select group. Now, my grid is grouped by account type and shows the count of cases for each. I'll also change the net worth column to calculate the average, so I can see the average net worth for each account type. Next, let's look at another report design. I want to see a visualization of onboarding requests by month. For the design, I have a variety of options to choose from, like pie charts, KPIs, or line charts. I'll use a line chart, which is good for time-based data. Now, some more configurations appear. I'll ensure the x-axis uses the timestamp field, but now my chart is hard to read because the data is day by day. In the column, I can click into the context menu and group it by month. That's better, but I don't really care about cases before 2023, so I'll add a filter to remove the older data. Now, my line chart is much more readable and only shows the data I care about. Next, I can break the data down further to show the different account types. To the x-axis, I'll add another category and choose customer account type. Now, you can see that there are three lines in the chart, one for each account type. I noticed something interesting about my data, that there was a drop of joint accounts in November 2023. I wonder what else I can learn, so I'll switch to viewing mode and use AI Copilot. With a few clicks of the suggested questions, or by entering my own, I can get some actionable insights on my data. I'll make a note to follow up with my team later. Now, let's say I just received a question from my manager. What's the average net worth of customers being onboarded right now? Back in the data catalog, I can go to the guided experience, which is useful when you want to explore your data. It'll prompt me to select the criteria for my report so I can describe what I'm looking for. I'll choose average, onboarding cases, and net worth as the field. As I go, the report builds. To refine it more, I'll click Create Report. I'll add a filter and change the label. I also want this KPI to be formatted in US dollars. I'll go to the net worth column and click the context menu, then format numbers to change how the number is displayed. Now that I've created a few reports, let's go back to the Process HQ homepage. Here, you'll find the reports and dashboards you've saved and those that are shared with you. Click the context menu for your reports to share, update, duplicate, and delete them. I'll share the reports I just created so everyone who has access to the dataset can see them. Now that I have created and shared my reports, it's easy to combine them into a dashboard. I'll click New Dashboard. In the Dashboard Builder, I can drag and drop reports into a layout. As you can see, I can use the reports that I built, as well as reports that are shared with me. A good layout is KPIs at the top, charts in the middle, and grids at the bottom. Now, my team has a one-stop-shop dashboard where we can all go to see the latest data about customer onboarding and even update onboarding cases directly as we do our work. Because the reports will update as new cases are added or changed, we can keep a close eye on trends and progress and make better business decisions.